In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Good morning, brothers and sisters. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Show us, O Lord, your mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison. Kyrie eleison. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that the coming solemnity of your Son may bestow healing upon us in this present life and bring us the rewards of life eternal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. I am the Lord, there is no other. I form the light and create darkness. I make well-being and create woe. I, the Lord, do all these things. Let justice descend, O heavens, like dew from above. Like gentle rain, let the skies drop it down. Let the earth open and salvation bud forth. Let justice also spring up. I, the Lord, have created this. For thus says the Lord, the creator of the heavens, who is God, the designer and maker of the earth, who established it, not creating it to be a waste, but designing it to be lived in. I am the Lord, there is no other. Who announced this from the beginning and foretold it from of old? Was it not I, the Lord, besides whom there is no other God? There is no just and saving God but me. Turn to me and be safe, all you ends of the earth. For I am God, there is no other. By myself I swear, uttering my just decrees and my unalterable word. To me every knee shall bend, by me every tongue shall swear, saying, only in the Lord are just deeds and power. Before him in shame shall come all who vent their anger against him. In the Lord shall be the vindication and the glory of all the descendants of Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let the clouds rain down the just one, and the earth bring forth a savior. I will hear what God proclaims. The Lord, for he proclaims peace to his people. Near indeed is his salvation to those who fear him, glory dwelling in our land. Kindness and truth shall meet, justice and peace shall kiss. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and justice shall look down from heaven. The Lord himself will give benefits. Our land shall yield its increase. Justice shall walk before him, and salvation along the way of his steps. Alleluia, alleluia. 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 Raise your voice and tell the good news. Behold, the Lord comes with power. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. At that time, John summoned two of his disciples and sent them to the Lord to ask, "Are you the one who is to come, or should we look for another?" When the men came to the Lord, they said, "John the Baptist has sent us to you to ask, 'Are you the one who is to come, or should we look for another?'" At that time, Jesus cured many of their diseases, sufferings, and evil spirits. He also granted sight to many who were blind. And Jesus said to them in reply, "Go and tell John what you have seen and heard. The blind regain their sight. The lame walk, the lepers are cleansed, the deaf hear, the dead are raised, the poor have the good news proclaimed to them, and blessed is the one who takes no offense at me." The Gospel of the Lord. In the first reading, we see how the works of creation speak of God as the only God, as the true one God. When we contemplate a sunset, when we see the beauty of the sea, when we see the beauty of creation, it all speaks of God. God's beauty, God's goodness, God's truth. And they invite us to believe in God, to worship God, to thank God for all his goodness, for the works of creation. It is like the Bible of nature. We can read who God is through his works. But of course, we have to be sincere and we have to seek the truth. We have to go beyond creation to know that truth. There is a lot of contamination in our reason, in the sense that how many times we have heard people saying that God does not exist. So, of course, our reason is affected, and therefore it's difficult sometimes to read that Bible in nature. But it is possible. It is possible. There are you can see many philosophers, many, many Greek philosophers speaking of the one, the origin of everything we see. But then here in this first reading of the prophet Isaiah, we see how the prophet foretells the coming of the Messiah. Notice what he says. Let justice descend, O heavens, like dew from above. Who is the just one? Who is the one coming from heaven? Jesus Christ. Like gentle rain, let the skies drop it down. Let the earth open and salvation bud forth. So it's speaking of the coming of Christ. And when he's born, salvation buds up, bud forth. So here we see the prophet Isaiah foretelling the coming of the Messiah. In today's gospel, we see that Jesus' works of salvation speak that he is the one sent by God, that he is the Messiah. If in the first reading we see how creation speaks of the one true God, that we have to worship him and praise him, as we read God's revelation, natural revelation in creation, in Jesus Christ, through his works, through his miracles, we see that he is the one sent by God. All these works, all these miracles testify that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, our Savior, the Messiah promised by God and prepared by the prophets, foretold by the prophets. He's the just one who came down from heaven like dew from the skies. His justice, his salvation. Now, can we be messengers of the fact that Christ is our Savior? Do we have proofs that tell us that Christ, only Christ, is the Savior of the world? Of course, yes. Of course, yes. Some people might ask you, is Christ the one who came, or should we look for another? Some people might ask you this, and you would say, yes, he cured my blindness. He made me walk. He gave me a new life. I was dead and he raised me up. He forgave my sins. I was delivered from the slavery of my sins. I have hope. Before I was hopeless. I didn't know that there was eternal life. And Christ opened for me the gates of heaven. My family was breaking. And Christ saved my marriage. I was alone and lost, and Christ showed me the truth. He gave me light in my path. I didn't know how to handle difficult times, and Jesus gave me the strength through his grace, through the sacraments, through his church, so that I can keep going. You can speak your own works may speak of Christ as the Savior of the world. Your own testimony is like that Bible who people who do not know Christ may read so they may come to believe. Notice what we heard in the first reading. Turn to me and be safe, all you ends of the earth, for I am God, there is no other. Turn to me and be safe. Look at my works. Look at what I have done for you. Turn to me and be safe. May the people who surround us, may that people turn to the Lord and be saved as they see the works God has done in us. We can also say, when it is very interesting to see here in this parish, there is a man who can speak and he can hear. That's a fact. And he's a great believer. You know, how can that man came to believe in Jesus Christ when he has not been able to listen and to speak? Because we come to believe as we hear the word of God. as someone speaks to us about Christ. That's a miracle. That is a true miracle. But how he came to believe? Because he saw signs. Because we do not only speak through words, through our lips, but also through signs. You know, signs is a language for the deaf. So your own signs, your own testimony of life, is a way you speak to others who are deaf, who cannot see, who cannot speak. They cannot believe, but because maybe no one have come to them to proclaim the good news, but they can have eyes to see your signs, God's signs in you, so that they may come to believe. So let us share with others what Christ has done in us. Not our perfection, not our perfection, but how Christ, despite our weaknesses and defects, despite the fact that we're sinners, have done wonders in our lives. Let us pray in silence. Let us pray, brothers and sisters, for the church, the world, and for one another. Your response is, come, O Lord, and save us. Let us pray for the Pope, the Holy Father. We pray for bishops and the shepherds of the Church of Christ, that they may help us to believe more and more in Christ, in his works. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray for civil leaders and politicians for their conversion, that they may turn to the Lord and be saved as they contemplate God's works in creation, especially the greatest creation God has ever made, which is the human being. They may contemplate God's image and likeness in us and realize the dignity of the human being. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray for the sick, the dying, the elderly, those who have lost their jobs. We pray for broken families, for broken marriages. We pray for their healing. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray for each one of us so that we may come testify to the truth. Christ is the truth. Christ is the way to eternal life. May we proclaim through our words and works that only Christ, only Jesus Christ, is God alone. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray especially for the souls in purgatory. Let us pray for our loved ones who has passed away. Let us pray to the Lord. God of heaven and earth, listen to the prayers that we humbly present to you, trusting in your divine providence. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. For the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. For the vine, the work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the sacrifice of our worship, Lord, we pray, be offered to you unceasingly to complete what was begun in sacred mystery and powerfully accomplished for us, your saving work, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which we now dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread through all the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Nelson our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you through all the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Behold, our Lord will come with power and will enlighten the eyes of his servants. Let us pray. We implore your mercy, Lord, that this divine sustenance may cleanse us of our faults and prepare us for the coming feasts. Through Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen.